Good day, everyone. Welcome to the CPU Gospel Hour. This is another hour of spreading the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. I'm Dr. Evangelica Gesto Padernilla, your host for today's Gospel Hour. This Gospel Hour is under the direction of the University Church of Central Philippine University. The president of our university is Dr. Teodoro C. Robles. There are three spirit-filled presentations, or spirit-filled worship services in our church every Sunday. The first service begins at 7 o'clock in the morning. The second is in mid-morning at 9:30. And the third, which is what we call the Vesper service, is at 5:30 in the afternoon. Today's Gospel Hour is a recorded video presentation of the second worship service at 9:30 a.m. That was a very beautiful worship. I hope that as the parts of the worship service unfolds, wherever you are, your spirit will join us in the joyful praises and adoration of our University Church congregation and the beautiful and harmonious melody, choir, the music of the choir, and also the fervent prayer of our pastor, and then of course, the powerful sermon of our pastor. The sermon was really touching, soul touching, and very, very comprehensive for and challenging for all the audience. So, may you all have a meaningful and inspiring worship experience today as you open your hearts and hearts to God's presence and the workings of the Holy Spirit. To God be the glory.
And we just want to thank Him for the freedom to worship Him in spirit and in truth. And today, we bless the Lord for the presence of 8 sections of religion and ethics classes under Pastor Jevijaira Constantino. May I request the RE students to please stand? RE students? Okay. So, wow. Welcome, Ged, no? Okay, you may sit down now. Pastor JV, ara sa likod, thank you for facilitating for your class that they were able to come and worship with us. So, sa mga religion and ethics students, you are very much welcome. And if you want to join the activities of the University Church, you are very much welcome. Especially those who are away from home, if you are finding a church away from your home church, you are very much welcome to make UC as your home church. It is my prayer that we will have a meaningful worship experience together. And so, shall we all stand and welcome one another by singing "Welcome to the Family."
Family, we're glad that you have come to share your life with us. As we grow in love and may we always be to you what God would have us be, a family all.
Please be seated. As we prepare our hearts and attune our hearts unto God.
Praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being. Praise His holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like eagles.
Father of glory.
Let us pray. Our loving Heavenly Father, thank you for the privilege to gather here to praise and worship you. Thank you for sustaining us with your strength and wisdom. Thank you that you enable us to be still and know that you are our God. I pray for our preacher. Empower him as he delivered to us your word. I pray for the congregation. Give us heavenly wisdom to understand your word. Be with us, Father God. Fill us with your spirit and make us one. May our words will dwell in our actions, and even the secret thoughts of our hearts be a part of your worship this morning. We entrust you everything. In your mighty name we pray. Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Shall we be seated, please?
I can see in the stars that shine and the birds above. I can feel in a hug so tight the wonder of your love, God.
Good morning, everyone. Today is our Kids and Moving Up and Sunday School Teachers Dedication Sunday. So I would like to request Ma'am Alog to recognize the children who will be promoted from the next level.
Good morning. We are so proud to promote 35 pupils who regularly attend our Kids Zone every Sunday. And may I request them, as I call your name, please come up on stage to get your token. We have from nursery to kindergarten, Fiora Katrina G. Dioso, Colleen Limoso, and Judah Oliver Canonigo. From kindergarten to younger primary class, we have Yusok Jong, Sean G. M. Alog, Aliyah Jade Mirasol. And then from younger primary class to older primary class, we have AJ Perocho, Dave Lawrence Abelarde, Yasmin Margaret Limbungan, Caitlin Tamayo, Lucas Paul Imbang, Val Nathaniel Gilbolinga, Maxine Julian Agriam, Prince Jedrick Pauya, and Caitlin Hardinel. From older primary class to juniors, we have Dylan Mispashan, Christina Angela Villaflor, Tyrene Isabel Jimenea, Hannah Lynette Caballero, Ardi Orhen Angeles, Mark Orland Centino Jr., Jed Matthew Palmehar, Jillian Christian Benvenida, and Dawn Ann Farillon. From junior class to high school, Sam Isaac Alog, Daniel Faith Palmehar, Joshua Ray Filonco, Sherwin J. Sumalakay, Fitz William Carnate, Kian Vincent Calabio, Limniel Gardose, Kenshen Bonitilio, Joshua Filonco, Maisel Joyce Villanueva, and Bori Yu. Congratulations. We would like to thank you for your continued support to the Kids Zone, the Children's Ministry of this University Church, and to the parents for not only sending the children, but by bringing them in the Kids Zone. To God be all the glory.
May I request all the Kids Zone pupils to face the altar for a special prayer for you. Face the altar, please. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, for the lives of our children. Truly, your word is true. Children are a heritage from the Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the joy they are giving us, especially in the community of faith. We also celebrate today the spiritual milestone in their journey. Thank you, Lord, for the Kids Zone ministry, that through this ministry we become obedient to your command to impress upon the hearts and minds of our children the love of the Lord. And I pray that you will continue to mold these lives, Lord, to become a blessing to your church and to their families. May you continue to uphold and mold the lives of these little children. It is your promise that you who started a good work in their lives is able to finish it, to accomplish it in your own perfect time. And so, Lord, thank you for the Kids Zone ministry. May you continue to use the Kids Zone as an avenue for spiritual growth of our children. And so we commit them to you. May you continue to guide them in your path. May your light, your word, become their guide on a daily basis. Spare them, Lord, from destruction and from any force that would try to snatch these little children away from you. Always keep them safe in the hollow of your hands. We entrust this prayer in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
This time, the Sunday school teachers and Kids Zone volunteers, I will only call the new volunteers for Kids Zone. Miss Ada Zaire May Villanueva, Miss Geraldine Salavio, and Mylon Silva. Please come forward. For the adult Sunday school teachers, we have Dr. Daphne Faith Estrada, bag-uni sila ha, and Esther Silis, Pastor Joe Labias for the Special Child Ministry. And for our new student pastors, we have Buena May Barato, Pastor Rowena Faeldonia, and Pastor Rodeline Talaman. I am calling all the Sunday school teachers and Kids and volunteers to please come forward. And another, the adult Sunday school teachers, Mrs. Evelyn Buensoceso.
Trust and obey. May I request the teachers to please stay for prayer? Let us pray. Lord, we just rejoice over the fact that you continue to raise up in our midst people who love you, Lord. People who just love to study your word. But most of all, we are very grateful for the lives of people who want to pass on the legacy of faith to the next generation. We thank you, Lord, for the presence of Kids Zone volunteers and teachers who continue to use their gifts to mold the lives of our children and young people, and also even the adult believers. We thank you, Lord, because this church continues to obey your word that the community of faith needs to study the Word of God daily for us to grow in the love and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, we celebrate the ministry of these teachers through the Kids Zone. And we bank upon your word, your promise that says, every time your word is proclaimed, either through preaching or teaching, it will not return to you void, but will accomplish its purpose in the lives of your people. And so we just pray that the seeds of faith they are planting will be received openly by the students, and they will allow these words to grow in their hearts so that it will produce fruits of peace and righteousness. And so we thank you, Lord, for the lives of these teachers. We dedicate their ministry to you, for you to prosper and to bless. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Let us put our hands together for our teachers.
Thank you. We have a token for our teachers. Thank you for your love and support. And we have additional teachers and professional, Engineer Rizal De Harder and Mr. Emmanuel Bautista.
This time, may I request the RE students to please stand. I would like to offer a special prayer for all of you. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for this time that we could worship you. We could offer you the highest praise and worship
because we believe that you alone deserves our highest adoration. We thank you, Lord, not only for what you have done in the lives of your people, but for who you are. You are our gracious, merciful, and loving God, forever faithful in the lives of your people. We thank you, Lord, for the presence of our students from the Religion and Ethics Department, 8 classes all in all. This is no accident that they are here, and that they are here at Central Philippine University. Truly, you have brought them here. We thank you for the opportunity that you have given them to be in school, to pursue their dreams. When many young people in our country were not able to enroll because of some constraints. And it is my prayer that these students will appreciate that. We continue to be grateful for that opportunity and make the most of it. And so, Lord, I pray that you will continue to mold their lives, grant them dedication and focus in their studies, that they will be able to finish strong, that the sacrifices of their parents and guardians will not be in vain. I am pretty sure that there will be a lot of temptations that they will be facing along the way. They will arrive in the crossroads of their lives when they have to make choices. But it is my prayer that when they arrive at the crossroads of their lives, they will make godly decisions. Decisions that will fuel their dreams, that will fulfill your beautiful purpose for their lives. Choices that will be a source of joy to their family, to their community. Always grant them wisdom, Lord, to choose what is right, what is just, and what is loving. Spare them from spirits of mediocrity and apathy. And inspire them to be excellent in anything that they do. Bless their families as well, especially their parents who are offering them support, parents and guardians. Thank you, Lord. May you cause them to seek your will in their lives, that through Central Philippine University and its programs, they will be able to deepen their relationship in you, Lord Jesus, that they will know you personally as their Lord and Savior, that they will build their lives on a firm foundation. And so, I humbly commit them to you, Lord. You said that you are able to keep whatever we have committed to you, even our own lives, our dreams, our aspirations. And so I entrust them to you. You may all be seated, RE students. Lord God, I continue to pray for our Christ Emphasis Week, which will kick off with the opening celebration on August 9. I pray that these convocations will be an avenue for the preaching of the gospel, and most of all, for people to respond to the call of Christ. We pray for the speakers, for the Christian Life Committee, for volunteers, campus organizations, and everyone who is involved in our CEW. We entrust everything to you, Lord. We continue to believe that it's not by might nor by power, but always by your Spirit. Lord God, we are living on a dangerous time. We are experiencing a lot of epidemic sa ammonia health. A lot of people are suffering from diseases, especially dengue. I pray, Lord, that you will protect us from this pestilence. Spare your people from danger. We beg you, Lord, have mercy on us. Heal our land. So we ask for your protection, for your safekeeping, and for those who are already afflicted with dengue or whatever disease, we pray for your healing touch. Heal your people. We entrust you everything, Lord. We entrust you our lives. We entrust you our journey. We entrust you our family. If there are things that hinder us from coming to you, forgive us from our sins. Cleanse us from our unrighteousness and make us worthy to face your throne of grace. This is our prayer in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, oh Lord. Great is thy faithfulness.
May I request everyone to please stand as we read the word of the Lord. Second Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 to 15 says, "Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. Now, he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food, will also supply and increase your store of seed, and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way, so that you can be generous on every occasion. And through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. This service that you perform is not only supplying the needs of the Lord's people, but is also overflowing in many expressions of thanks to God. Because of the service by which you have proved yourselves, others will praise God for the obedience that accompanies your confession of the gospel of Christ, and for your generosity in sharing with them and with everyone else. And in their prayers for you, their hearts will go out to you because of the surpassing grace God has given you. Thanks be to God for His indescribable gift. This is the word of the Lord. Please be seated.
Thank you, choir, for that beautiful song and also sa ng reminder na to seek first the kingdom of God. Again, good morning. Mayong aga gid sa tanan. RE classes, we're so happy to have you with us. And also, I would like to welcome my classmate, Maribel Arandela Bumbain. Dai, will you please stand? Nabingin si Maribel, kumakatindog siguro ah. Inigini sa gusto nga ipakilala, pasige lang. Pasinsya lang. Classmate ko from kindergarten, elementary, and high school. No? There's a booklet, a small booklet, that says, what to do when the worship is boring. Ano ko nung himuon kung doka boring sa worship? May one of the suggestions of that, in that booklet was that you yawn, no? Tis tingin niyo ang panguyab if it is indeed contagious, no? Panguyab ka kuno kon bala madalamong iban. Another suggestion was that when you pray, during the prayers, you count aloud those who are not closing their eyes, no? Kunway kuno ka pa yung sumata. Pag-isipon mo, ano? Well, we are so happy that our worship is not boring, but for sure we have truly worshiped the Lord in spirit and in truth, no? Kag nasadyahan kita sa pag-worship sa Ginoo. Well, the text that was read to us this morning, or what the text that was read to us a while ago, says about offering. Although this is 2,000 years ago, but it has some powerful principles that can apply in our offering today, no, sa atong paghatag subong. As a matter of fact, si San Pablo, Paul, devoted two entire chapters, no, to this offering, but without mentioning money. Why did siya nag-mention sa money? So, sa atong pagtuon, sa subong aga, we're going to learn that offering should be the happiest and the most joyful experience in the worship service. Kinanglan ko ng offering among pinakasadya ng experience sa atong pag-worship. You know, the problem is, many people have been told that, kapatid ka mo sa string statement, give till it hurts. Give till it hurts. And that's exactly where they've been stuck for years. So ang aton offering ko isa daw hindi masadya, no? Kundi it's like pulling teeth gapagabot ka bala. Ti daw si sino na sadyan magpagabot undo, no? But this morning there are three principles that will bring you to a place where you'll give cheerfully, no? Nga mangin malipayon ka sa paghatag. So ano ini nga mga principles, and we're going to learn that this morning, okay? So the first principle is give. Okay, cheerful giving. So first principle, when I give, my attitude is more important than the amount. Maghatag kita, ang aton attitude among pinaka-importante, sobra pa sang sa amount. The Bible says, each man should give what he has decided in his heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion. So, duha ka tinaga, reluctantly and compulsion. So, pamangkutan yung inyo ko galingon. Ini bala description sang inyo bala tiyagon when you give. Nga as if gapang alagag ka, you are reluctant sa paghatag. Or as if napilitan ka lang nga maghatag. So does this describe the attitude you have when you give? Actually, there are three wrong attitudes that people have when they give. Mga sala ang attitude. Ang primero nga attitude, amo sini, no? I've got to give to help God out. Okay? So a person who gives with this attitude simply sees the need, nakita yung need. And even though they may not care about the need, this person recognizes somebody has to give. So it might as well be them. So daw may balatsyagon ka bala nga, buligan ta na lang niyang Ginoo, buligan ta lang niyang simbahan, na, no? Or nagapanguna-una siya, ay, kaluluoy man sang Diyos, no? Why gid sang mabulig sa iya, ako na lang mabulig, no? Or balatsyagon bala nga, oh, maayo lang kay may kwarta ako subong nga hatag nakaibulig sa siningan. Lucky for God that I have some money to help him out. Why man na ni mo ginasiling sa imo panghuna-huna o kun sa imo verbally why mo ginambal, but you're thinking about it. But of course, we always remember that God knows our thoughts. God knows the intents of our hearts. So whenever God hears those kinds of thoughts, surely, as it says in Psalm 2, verse 4, the one enthroned in heaven laughs. Kung magamuna pang una-una, tanginu, uga kadlaw, no? Actually, God doesn't need your and my money. As a matter of fact, God says in Psalm 50, verse 10, for every animal of the forest is mine, and the cattle of a thousand hills. Iyas ang Ginoo. Actually, when we give, we are not doing God a favor. Tandaan natin ina. You're not doing God a favor. Actually, He's doing us a favor by allowing us to participate in what He is doing. Amo nang gakatabo. So, sa lang attitude, nabuligan ko ang Diyos, no? Ang Ginoo ay gakinanglan sa imubuling, no? Ikaduhang attitude, I've got to pay God's tax. Panuhuna-una, tablanga ang aton offering, the buwis, no? Tax. Some people consider giving God a tithe as a law that they must follow, like paying an income tax to the government. This is in sa inyo ang cheerfully nga naghahatag sang inyong tax. Masami daw nabugatan kita maghahatag sang tax. In the Old Testament, the tithe was basically a tax. Every Jew gave 10% of the resources to maintain the operation of the temple. Now, I believe in tithing. But I believe that it is only a starting point for us. Because we are not under the law anymore. But we are under the grace. But shouldn't we who are under grace want to do more than those who were under the law? Masami mamangkot, Pastor, should I give my tithe based on gross income or on my net? Well, tithing isn't some legalistic rule that we follow where we have to, you know, meticulously figure out every cent. But tithing is a guideline we use for giving our love offering to God. Sa tuduod lang, tithing isn't even commanded in the New Testament. Jesus never commanded us to tithe. But Jesus commended or praised tithing. In Luke chapter 11, verse 42, woe to you, Pharisees, sambal sang atong Ginoo, because you give God a tenth of your mint, rue, and all other kinds of garden herbs, but you neglect justice and love of God. You should have practiced the latter without leaving the former undone. You know, the Pharisees were so meticulous about tithing that they figure out about how to give one-tenth of their garden herbs, and that's legalism. Jesus said they ought to have tithe, but should not have neglected the more important issues of the heart, like justice and love of God. So if you're thinking, kung hindi ka mag-tithe, ang Ginoo mapadalas ang mga BIR agent sa imo, langit doon nga BIR agent, kagsukton ka, then sala ang imo attitude about giving. You know? Ikatatlo, nga sala pagin nga attitude is this, I've got to got God's riches. Kwaon ko ang mga blessings ang Ginoo. You know, may mga tao, kag may mga ministries nga nagatudlo sini, no? Prosperity, health, and wealth. Ang mensahe is that you give to God, meaning you give to their ministries, and then God will heal you of your sicknesses, and He will make you rich. No? Kung sa man notice mo nga ining mga nagawali da kag sa television, nagasuksok ang tipara, may problema, ilamata, no? Pura mo nang ilag na tudlo. Well, ini nga pagtudlo, this series introduces, it is as if you're making God like a slot machine. As long as ginahulog mo ng coin, ang Ginoo mag-bless sa imo. Well, God does say, if you give, it will be given to you. But the promise is only good if you keep on giving. Meaning, it becomes your way of life. But when you start getting greedy, you hang on to God's blessing instead of the giver of the gift, then the cycle is broken. So these are three wrong attitudes. Now, ano iya ang correct nga attitude when we give? It's found in these five simple words in verse 7. God loves a cheerful giver. God loves a cheerful giver. Oh, masaling kita nga, oh, ang Diyos may pinilian, hindi lang planga sa Diyos ang tanan-tanan. Doesn't God love everybody? Of course, God loves everyone. But He has a special love reserved for those who give cheerfully to Him. No, prasman sa ato, nga ginikanan, no? Parents, we love all our children equally, no? Don't we? Of course, but sometimes when a child is specially loving, pinaanggaon, and kung ina nga bata, very obedient sa imo, you find it easier to love the child. And I think that's what God is saying here. He loves everyone, but He finds it's easier to love His children who give to Him not grudgingly, but cheerfully. Actually, the word cheerful is the word hilaros in Greek, which means, or di tagin ko ang aton English word, nga hilarious. Here's how Jack Taylor described a hilarious giver in his book, God's Miraculous Plan of Economy. This is what he said. I wish I could draw you a picture of a hilarious giver. If I could, I would capture the look of uncontained delirium, electrifying enthusiasm, ecstatic expectation, a countenance exploding with delight, almost giddy, always gleesome. A hilarious giver has discovered what it really is more blessed to give than to receive. So how can you start giving hilariously rather than reluctantly or grudgingly? Well, the answer is found in understanding the power of a seed. Amo ning ikaduha nga principle. I should give joyfully like a farmer planting seeds. In the middle section of parte sa giving in Sulat ni San Pablo, Paul inserts a farming metaphor. And he writes, "He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness." There is a irrevocable law. No? Law nga hindi mabawi o kung hindi mo maguba. No? It is irrevocable law that has been established that is called God's law of the harvest. God's law of the harvest. Hindi mo ini maguba, no? Hindi mo na ni, kung may law of gravity, amo manisa, it is irrevocable. And there are four dimensions to this law that when you understand it, you can give joyfully and generously, na? So ano ini, no nga law? Kung ano ining mga points na diri? Anong mga dimensions? Number one, God's law of the harvest, God always supplies the seed. All planting begins with a seed. Seeds comes in all shapes and sizes, but they all have one remarkable quality. Ano ini? They, all seeds possess an indwelling life. In this context, a seed represents the resources God has given you. Ano ining resources? This includes your money, your talents, your abilities, your health, and any other blessing you can use for God's glory. Ang tanan natin nga seeds, all our seeds have been supplied by God. Because you can't make it. Hindi mo na yung maubra. Humanity can only discover seeds and plant seeds, but only God can create a seed. A scientist has never formulated a seed from nothing. Ang Diyos lang nakahimo sini. And this life force within a seed is trapped. Ining kabuhi di sa seed is trapped until certain conditions apply. Ang seed, pwede mo nga pa sigahan sa suga, no? You can enshrine it, you can extol it, you can hallow it, or you can horn it, but it can never produce life on its own. It's dead. the seed must die before it can produce life. As Jesus said, I tell you the truth, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds. So Jesus wasn't talking about farming. Actually, he was referring to our life. He was referring to his life, his body, to die and be buried before they would come an amazing multiplication of life that sprung from his resurrection. When we plant, when seeds are planted, when seeds are watered, things begin to happen in the body of the seed. Anong kakatabo sa seed? Well, hindi niya mapunggan ang life within him. And then, it will respond to chemicals and soils and moistures by expanding and then bursting. Pag-burst siya, magwaaya gamot. No? He will sprout some stems for sunlight. Seeds are a miraculous entity and only God can supply them to us. God always supplies seeds. Secondly, I'll always reap what I plant. That means you won't get any beans if you plant tomatoes. No? Kung anong imo tanom, amo man na ang imo anihon. Kung gusto ka mag-harvest ng peanuts, matanom ka man eh. No? So this law of likeness, ining law of likeness, also translate in the spiritual realm. If you want God's best blessing, then give Him also your best. Makamaton kaya sa pagpakamayo man sa Ginoo sa best. And this is true in every area of your life. For example, if you plant encouragement in others, mag-encourage ko sa iban, you also reap a number or a bumper crop of encouragement from other people. If you plant respect in others, mag-aani ka man sa respect sa iban nga tao. If you plant love, you'll reap love. God's word says, do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. A man reaps what he sows. And the one who sows to please his sinful nature, from that nature will reap destruction. And the one who sows to please the Spirit, from the Spirit will reap eternal life. So tandaan natin, anong aton ginatanom, amo man ang aton anihon. And then, ano pagiging nga principle, the law of the harvest. Number three principle, I'll always reap later than I plant. You don't reap a crop from the gift you plant immediately. No? Why isang mangunguma, nga sa diin, insigida pagtanom niya, ani sa dason, no? A farmer must have patience. He cannot circumvent the process. He can only participate in it and wait until the seed has finished his work. We're such a fast food, no, and microwave culture nga gusto naton ang resulta insigida. Right away. In fact, kung pwede pa lang, no, mapadasig tapagin. But God says, let us not become weary in doing good. For at the proper time, you will reap a harvest if we do not give up. So when you give money to mission, well, it may take some time before the money will result in the harvest of souls. In Cambodia, sa mga kabukiran natin, nga mga ginapangbuligan, no? Sa Thailand, in other places, nga naging nagabulig kita. When you give love to someone who is unlovely, budlay palang gaon. But when you keep on sharing that love to that person, there may not be an immediate response, but the seed will result in a harvest if you don't give up. Na? So I'll always reap later than I plant. And then fourthly, I'll always reap in proportion to how many seeds I plant. And this is the law of multiplication. It's simple mathematics at this point. Plant a few seeds, you get a small harvest. Plant many seeds and reap a huge harvest. If you plant zero seeds, you reap zero because a million times zero is still zero. Ang smart nga mangunguma, no, doesn't hoard his seed. Why yung ginatago yung seed? He plants it joyfully. As Paul writes, remember this, whosoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whosoever sows generously will also reap generously. When I served a church in the northern part of Iloilo, and it was a rural area where there's a lot of farmers, damo to mga nguma, ano? And these were men who planted, you know, many hectares of rice. And these farmers were some of the most patient and spiritually mature people. Why? Because they lived God's law of the harvest. When they planted, they just didn't plant few seeds, kundi damo gid nga binhi ang ilan na tanom, no? And they joyfully planted thousands of seeds because they understood that he who plants sparingly will reap sparingly, but he who plants bountifully or generously will also reap generously. The reason God gives us seed is so that we can plant them. Ang aton mga talento, ang aton mga gift, ginhatag sa Ginoo sa aton, para nga itanom natin ini. As John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist Church, had a simple personal financial policy. Get all you can, save all you can, give all you can. Amo na ang principle ni John Wesley. Today, you know, people are so selfish that the popular philosophy in our culture is this: get all you can all you get, sit on your can, and poison the rest. No? Amo na gakatabo. But God made us to be generous with seeds He gives us. Remember, we're not talking only about money here. We're talking about all the blessings that we receive from the hand of God. Hindi mo maaway, no? Ang law of the harvest. It is irrevocable. You can only get in on it and plant the seeds God's give you. So pamangkot, are you joyfully planting God's seeds? No? And then katapusan ng principle, and let me end here. I give out of gratitude for the priceless gift God has given me. Kung naghahatag man ako, if ever naga-support ako sa church or naghahatag ko sa account for offering, this is because of my gratitude for the priceless gift God has given me. Amuning final verse sa section ni Paul. He burst forth with thanksgiving, with a doxology, giving the reason why these Gentiles, these Christian Gentiles, ought to give sacrificially to the Jewish Christians in Jerusalem. Humbly San Pablo in verse 15, thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. He says, we give out of thanksgiving to God, who has given us an indescribable gift. This indescribable gift is eternal life in Jesus. Nga ang indescribable ininga gift? Because first, the Father who has given it. God is too powerful to fit into any human description. Ahambal ni Chris Tomlin sa iya nga kanta, indescribable, no? Uncontainable. You place the stars in the skies and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. You know, ang isa sang pinaka mahabal ko na natud-an ko dako parte sa Diyos is when nagbata ang akon misis sang first namon nga bata, no, sang kay Lovejoy, no? I learned more about God the first minute after my daughter was born. When I became a father, I realized I wanted to give my child everything that would benefit them. I found I love to shower my children with gifts. Hindi ni siya chore, no? O kung buluhaton nga ginafirsa ka. Like staying up at night, sa pagbulig, no? Mabuligan sila, mapahipo sila, matipan sila. It's not a chore, but it's a joy. Ti amo mana, our Heavenly Father gives us with the spirit of joy. Amo na siya maghatag sa aton. Secondly, this gift is indescribable because of the Savior who embodies it. No? the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Eternal life in Jesus. No? Illustration. For example, ining amuning eternal life, no? Amuning si Jesus. Ang eternal life, ara kay Jesus. So when you receive Jesus, you also receive eternal life. So in Jesus, ara eternal life. Eternal life is in Jesus, so you receive eternal life, you must receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And then thirdly, this gift is indescribable because of what it can do for you. Ang eternal life, anong mahimo sa eternal life sa imo? This gift removes the penalty of your sin. Nagahukas ang tanan-tanan nga penalty bangod sang imo sala. It makes you a new person. This gift, ining a gift, imputes or assign you. Ginasuklob sa imo ang righteousness ni Jesus and adopts you into the family of God. So this gift make you an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ. And it is through this gift that God, the Holy Spirit, comes and takes up residence in your heart. So amuni, ano ang mahimo sininga gift? It is indescribable gift. No? Gati upon why ka kay Jesus, why ka sa eternal life? Hindi mo makita ang eternal life sa ibang lugar, kundi sa kay Jesus lamang. So, when you give to God, are you giving grudgingly or reluctantly? Or do you find yourself cheerfully giving to God? If you want to give cheerfully, if you want to be a cheerful giver, you've got to understand that your attitude is more important than the amount. Recognize God's law of the harvest and start joyfully, extravagantly planting seeds, meaning the gift that the Lord has been blessing you. And give out a sense of gratitude for God's for the grace God has given you. If you can recall, let me end with this story. Sang tudod nga tabo kay Jesus. There was a time when Jesus healed 10 lepers. But you know, only one leper or one man returned to say thank you. Ma-recall nyo na nga story. And that is when Jesus saw the single man, it was a Samaritan, he asked, were there not 10 men healed? Hindi ba lang 10 ang naayo? Yeah, where are the other 9? My friend, don't be like those 9 men who left Jesus without saying thank you. I think Jesus was teaching us that generally, about 90% of people go through life never truly recognizing what God has done for them and falling at His feet to say thank you. Amo nang tao, no? Nagakalipat gid sa Dios. So are you going to be like that 90% of ungrateful people? Or will you step up and be like that man who fell at the feet of Jesus and show gratitude by becoming a channel of blessing to others? It is my prayer that you will make a commitment to be one who gives cheerfully to the Lord and for His glory. God bless you.
Let us now give our tithes, pledges, and offerings. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave Himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
us pray. O Lord, we open our hearts to the absolute wonder of your gifts to us. The gifts we bring today are but a pale reflection of your gratitude. In Jesus, your heart was fully open to us. Through Jesus, our hearts are open to you. Amen.
Please sit down for a while for some quick announcement or announcements. We would like to invite you to Hiligaynon Praise and Worship Concert, Himaya 2019, on August 2, 2019, that's a Friday, here at the University Church, 6 p.m. 5:30 p.m. So you will be hearing original compositions by Salmista, a group of Christian artists here in Iloilo. So again, August 2, 2019, 5:30 p.m. This is for free. Himaya 2019 concert. And also, there will be a general women's meeting today at 2 p.m. at the Student Center. So we are inviting all the women to attend this meeting. You will be hearing a lecture from Dr. Gemma Trasporto. This is a very important topic. The title of the lecture is What Every Woman Ought to Know. So this is a very interesting topic. So women, please attend the 2 p.m. Lecture and a meeting of the women's organization of our church. And we are inviting you for the School of Evangelism. I think somebody, Manangging Onyati, will invite us for this School of Evangelism.
Good morning, everyone. For those who truly, truly love the Lord with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength, nothing will please God more than see you tell people about his story. Join us. Go tell everyone that Jesus Christ is King. I would like to announce that the CPU UC School of Evangelism, or we call it SOE for short, we'll start again on August 4. This is a special class that teaches the step-by-step successful method of sharing or witnessing by the power of the Holy Spirit. You'll be trained to help spread the gospel in a prayerful and intelligent presentation to everyone you meet. Classes will be held on Sunday afternoons from 2 to 5 for 8 Sundays at the conference room of the church. Mr. Lambert Bias will be the instructor. In Matthew 4:19, the Lord commanded us to follow him and become fishers of men. Begin to share Christ as a way of life in your own Jerusalem, your home, your neighborhood, the university, your office, or even the factory where you work. It is an honor to be given the opportunity to serve God this way. It may be a sacrifice to some, but see that sacrifice turn to joy like no other when you are handed the privilege to serve our one true God, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. The program is free, snacks will be provided, and above all, the Lord will be very pleased. So on your way out, don't forget to sign up for the class. We can take only 10, first come, first serve. If you have further questions, please feel free to ask me or any one of the people from this church. Thank you, and may God bless you all.
Save your light, guiding love.
People of God, we are gathered here to worship. Now go out into the world to serve. May the love of God the Father, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
That is the end of our worship service. But before we close, I would like to read some of the announcements found in our bulletin, bulletin. These are the maintaining or sustaining activities that we are having, and of course, some significant events that we can look forward to in the near future. There will be a welcome for all visiting guests and friends, especially the 8th religious and education classes of Pastor Jiri C. Constantino, who are going to worship with us today. And then we have here the School of Evangelism, which is being held every 2 to 5 p.m. This will still be held on August 4, 2019, for 8 consecutive sessions. If you are interested to join the next batch of the School of Evangelism, kindly contact Pastor Roger Kimpo, Mr. Lamberto Baez, or Mrs. Rona Edemne for listing you. And then we will have a confirmation of the renewal of the pastors today. The church council voted to renew the call of our senior pastor, Reverend Chris Amor Solucian, and our associate pastor for outreach, Reverend Roger T. Kimpo. And also our CE director, Reverend Ruth G. Lunasco, for another three years of service. That is beginning this year. On July 26, 2019, the University Church members will be requested to confirm the renewal of their call. This will be done during the three worship services. We need at least two-thirds affirmative vote of members present and voting to confirm the action of the church council in calling all of those pastors that we have. Then there's our prayer meeting every Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. Everyone is invited to come, pray, and share experiences that will bless others. Prayer for the suffering churches of the world. This is the Open Door Daily Prayer Guide for Suffering Churches for the month of July and August. Copies of this announcement is now available. Please get your copy, that there will be a table after service from the church ports. You'll get a copy from there if you wish. Then we have the Kids on Children's Ministry, ages 16 and below. This continues to provide our children with Bible-based and fun learning experiences. Then we have the Gospel Hour, which is the University Church Sunday Second Worship Service. This will be live, live coverage of the service will be broadcasted on CPU TV, Facebook page, facebook.com/Central Philippine University TV every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. This is live. And then the recorded live video can still be viewed anytime, every day on the same Facebook page. The Christian Youth Regular Activities is every Sunday at 2:30 p.m. This is for Christian Youth Fellowship. And then there's a Youth Prayer Power every Friday at 5:30 p.m. Then there's the Fuse Joint Fellowship every first Sunday at 2:30 p.m. Student Center. That is all young people. All young people organizations are fused, and they come together for fellowship. And then these are all for now. This is Mambanji bidding you goodbye till next week. Again, on the same CPU Facebook page, www.facebook.com Central Philippine University TV Facebook, which you can view anytime, every day, next week. May God bless you all. Love you.